Welcome back to the show. Well, our theme show this morning is the year 1999. Do not adjust your television sets. I'll tell you what, it was a really memorable year when it came to crime. Let's welcome true crime author Amanda Howard to Studio 10. Welcome. Terrible things happened in 1999. It was quite bizarre reading all about it.
This is one of those terrible things. People wore this stuff and dressed like a crook even when they weren't.
Not just crimes against humanity in terms of fashion, but also terrible murders like Snowtown in South Australia. Talk us through that.
Yeah, well, Snowtown culminated in the arrest of the main characters in the Snowtown crimes. What happened was over several years, John Bunting and two of his friends, Mark Velasquez and Robert Wagner, murdered 12 people. So a lot of friends got involved. Actually, two of the victims, Barry Lane, who ended up in one of the barrels, was actually one of the killers as well.
And weren't they murdered for their Centrelink checks?
That was part of it. Bunting was one of these like Svengali sort of characters, and he created this pool of friends around him, and on a wall he had a massive spider web of pedophiles and those that he suspected of being pedophiles, as well as homosexuals. And they were just one by one.
So he thought he was a serial killer working towards a justified end. Okay.
Vigilante.
It was just so revolting. And I remember there was a film and I watched the first minute and then I had to turn the film off because I felt physically sick.
Australia does very good true crime films. And Snowtown is one of the best. The actors in that played the roles very well. And they actually used local people to bring that authenticity to the case. But, yeah, the violence that went on with Snowtown, they tortured their victims for hours. Bunting would actually sit there with his hand around the throat of his victims and just stare at them, watching for that moment where they went from life to death. It was that violent and gruesome. Yeah.
You've done a lot
of... Sorry. No, that's fine.
It's horrible, isn't it?
A little bit of spew in my mouth.
You've done a lot of research on serial killers. What makes them serial killers? What is it? How does it start?
There's no set serial killer in the world. There's no sort of book of this is what a serial killer is. I mean, we define them as that they've murdered several people, that there's a break between each killing. But a lot of them have different reasons. Jeffrey Dahmer, for example, killed because he wanted companionship. So the Snowtown guys killed purely because, one, that they wanted their welfare payments, but also they thought that they were doing their own vigilante justice.
Yeah.
So there's all different reasons.
Yeah,
all different.
It's all sick. Now, sadly, 1999 was also the year of the Columbine School massacre.
It's... Thankfully, only 12 people were killed, which is not a thankful thing.
No.
But it was actually meant to start about 10 minutes earlier, where they set a bomb in the cafeteria. We're actually seeing the footage later in that same cafeteria. Had the bombs gone off that the boys had set, more than 500 people would have been killed in that room alone.
Oh, really?
But they failed, thankfully.
I remember this playing out at the time, and kids were actually using their mobile phones to call news stations. Do you remember that?
That's right.
And newscasts were putting in America and the States were putting to air these panicked phone calls from kids, and there was a big kind of discussion about that later on. But it was one of the first kind of school massacres that we saw really play out like a sick version of reality TV, right? Mm.
Well, I mean, they were actually inspired by the Oklahoma terrorist attack from about a decade before, that they wanted to culminate that, and they saw the mass destruction there, which is why they'd built the bombs. The guns were meant to just be, when the explosions happened, they would just shoot them as they come out. But when they ticked down the time and said, those bombs didn't go off, we have to go in shooting, that's when they decided. Now, the big thing about Snowtown is that they actually stayed outside when the SWAT... Columbine, thank you. The SWAT team turned up because everyone had rung. They didn't go inside for 3 hours.
Wow.
They stayed outside. Now, that's why we now have the active shooter protocols that they go in, shoot to kill.
But they didn't do it at the Lind Cafe, did they?
That's a whole other topic.
We'll
change
do.
That too, I believe.
Yeah. We need to have the active shooter protocol that we need to go in before there are more lives taken, whereas they just sat outside and waited. In fact, the teacher, David Sanders, that died at Columbine, he was actually still alive for 3.5 hours after being shot.
Yes.
He died because no one got to him in time.
Well, Amanda Howard's latest book is out now. It's called Killer Australia. And if you are in Sydney tomorrow, you can actually meet Amanda in the flesh at the Books by the Bridge at Luna Park. Amanda, always nice chatting with you. Fascinating, at least. Yeah.